girl, I took my football everywhere, also to bed, every night. The ball smelled so bad that even my cat leapt from the pillow. An orange-coloured football for playing on snowy gravel fields. A 13-year-old dreaming about mastering the ball, escaping the fear of not fitting in. I no longer take the ball with me everywhere, but my dreams are still about football. Football where boys and girls, all colours, straights and queers, everyone is treated with equal respect and recognition. In 2010, World Cups were awarded by FIFA in unacceptable ways with unacceptable consequences. Human rights, equality, democracy, the core interests of football were not in the starting 11 until many years later. These basic rights were pressured on to the field as substitutes, mainly by outside voices. FIFA has addressed these issues, but there is still a long way to go. The migrant workers injured or families of those who died in the build-up to the World Cup must be cared for. FIFA, all of us, must take all necessary measures to really implement change. Zero tolerance towards corruption accelerates the growth of the women's game. FIFA must set the tone and lead. Dear President, dear Congress, I'm new here, and the girl with the orange ball has come far from home. I often get asked, how is it to work in a man's world? And I always answer, I don't. I do not work in a man's world. Football belongs to all girls and all boys in the world. So I truly share your belief that ours is indeed the beautiful and global game. So let us stand together and live up to the promise and dreams we give to everyone who takes that first kick of the ball.